Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will talk about how you can actually schedule tasks to run at reboots or how you can schedule tasks to run at a certain point of time. Namely, this connects to the previous tutorial as this is a follow-up, how you can set a script or a command to change the MAC addresses of your interfaces at startup. So every time you basically reset your computer or something like that, every time you turn off your computer and turn it back on, not only does it give you a random MAC address and anonymizes you further on wireless networks, but rather instead you are effectively making sure that you will absolutely never use your own real MAC address anywhere. That's not a bad idea. You might think to yourself, oh well, I can just, why would I need to do that? I can just change it every time I need to change it. Well, you forget, trust me. You don't think about it all the time, and it can be painstaking to think about it all the time, not a good idea, and you will find yourselves in a situation where you will forget when you will forget to do it and you will need to do it. That can cause a bit of inconvenience, not a good idea. It's far simpler to set a cron job once and it's gonna run every time you reboot your computer, change your MAC address, and that will be just perfect. In such a way you will effectively ensure that you will absolutely never on any Wi-Fi network use your own MAC address or on any network of any kind or sort. Now if we take a look in ifconfig, I don't actually have any wireless interfaces configured here, primarily because this is a virtual machine. We will be doing some of the things on my other machine, on Fedora, which is my host machine. But for the time being, we will use ETH0, my wired interface, as an example. But you can just as easily do this with any other interface that you have here. All that is really different is the name of the interface. So for example, this one is ETH0. Wireless one would be ETH1. On my Fedora one, on my Fedora OS, it's VLP2S0. That's the name of a wireless interface. Why they have named it so, I have no idea, but so it is. In any case, what you would need to do is, let's just go ahead and clear the screen first. There is something called cron jobs, so cron job in pretty much every Linux distribution out there. This is what you use in order to schedule tasks to run for you in an automated fashion. So what you need to type in is crontab --help, press enter. And there we go, we have a help menu. It's really small, there aren't that many options. The tool is fairly simple. You use -e to edit user's cron tab. You use -u to specify the user for which you wish to edit the cron tab. That's not a bad idea either if you have lots of users on the system or something of a kind. But other than that, by default, it will edit the cron jobs of a current user. So you can just type in, before we start typing it in, you can also list the user's cron tabs, delete the user's cron tabs, very important, and prompt before, you can also use -i always to prompt before deleting, primarily because when you delete something in Linux, it's not like in Windows, once you delete it, it's gone, and it's gone. There are some methods of retrieving that sort of information, but more likely than not, it's permanently gone. You will find it very difficult to retrieve information that you have deleted through the usage of terminal, for example using the rm command or something of a kind. Yeah, I've talked about this previously, but I just wanted to remind you because it is very important, and it has happened to me lots of times that I deleted something which I either could not retrieve or I could only retrieve it, but it was fragmented and there were only bits and pieces of it, so not a good idea. Anyway, enough about that. Let's go ahead and start editing our scripts that will run on startup. So just type in crontab --e, press enter, and there we go. We are prompted with this file. This is open with a VI editor, so we will need to go through some of the basics there. It says edit this file to introduce tasks to run by cron. I strongly advise reading through this entire file. It's very small. Like, look, it goes from here to here. So that's the entire README file. That's you just read it. See, I'm 99% sure that you will be able to understand pretty much everything that is written here. I will explain some of the things, but if you find anything unclear that you see here, feel free to pose it in the question section. Over here, the last line is actually the format. So you got minutes, you got day of the month, you got day of the week. You got a command for the meaning of each of these separate sections. You can read this file here. So mon is month, DOM is day of the month, this is hour, this is minute, and so on and so forth. So just go through this file, read through it, and you will understand this format to the fullest of extents. But for the time being, here is the command that I wish to use. In order for you to edit pretty much anything in VI, this is that VI is a Linux text editor, you need to open a file and then press I. Just go ahead and press I on your keyboard, letter I. And it says you are currently in the insert mode. You can see how I'm highlighting it now. It says insert. And now you can actually type things in. What we want to type in is at reboot space, and then type in the command Mac changer space dash r space eth0. That is the command that we use in order to randomize the MAC address of our ETH0 network interface. And here you have at reboot. So when do we want this to happen? At reboot. We want it to happen when we reboot our machine. Execute this command. If you wanted to run a script or something like that, you would just need to specify a path to that script and then a command to execute it. But for the time being, we're not going to use that. We're just going to use a command in order to randomize the MAC address of our network interface. So just press escape now to exit insert mode and press colon on your keyboard. So just press colon on your keyboard and you will be prompted with a command line here. In the command line, you need to type in W for write. So write these changes to a file. And then in addition to W, you also need to write Q, quit. After you've written the file to a file, I want you to quit the file. If this doesn't work, you can also add an additional argument, which is an exclamation mark, to forcibly do it. But there is no need. In this example, it's going to work. So write quit. There we go. It says installing new crontab. Excellent. So let's just go ahead and clear the screen. Type in ifconfig eth0. Wait, no, I don't want to use that one. I'll do mac changer dash s to show me the MAC address of my interface, eth0. Press enter, and you see it says permanent MAC, this one. Current MAC that we are using, same one pretty much. I don't know, this is the manufacturer, Cadmus Computer Systems, whatever. Just go ahead and reboot the computer, and after the reboot we will see a different MAC address there. Now you don't need to remember the whole MAC address to verify this, just remember the first two digits, the first two places actually, not digits. It was 08. So 08 were the first two places that were occupied in the MAC address. Once we reboot the system, I will start up the ifconf, actually not the ifconfig, I will use Mac changer from now on to actually verify the MAC addresses of my interfaces, even though that is not a good thing. You should really be using ifconfig primarily because it is a universal way of checking a MAC address on pretty much any Linux distro out there, while on the other hand, Mac changer is most likely only installed by default on a Kali Linux, and pretty much any other distro does not have it installed by default. So just go ahead and use ifconfig. Oops, no, I do not wish to log in as test. I wish to log in as root. So root test. There we go. We're being logged in at the moment. sorry for any delays. This is a virtual machine, so it's bound to have some slight delays, but surprisingly, I have found it very efficient. It's working at a relatively fast pace. Let's just go ahead and open up our terminal, type in ifconfig, and you can see that the hardware address has been changed indeed. This one is no longer 08, so to confirm this further, let's just go ahead and type in Macchanger show ETH0. Excellent. So you see permanent Mac is this, current Mac is this. It's of an unknown type, unknown manufacturer that is. You can take a look at the Macchanger help menu to specify the type of a Mac address that you want it to assign to your interface. You can play around with that. I strongly advise that you do. Again, if you have any questions in regards to that, feel free to post them. I will be more than happy to help you out in any way that I can. In any case, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.